Hi, about 2 years ago I have decided to make my own YouTube channel and share my experience as a jewelry cat designer. But in the past 2 years I was speaking Farsi, because I'm Iranian and for sure speaking Farsi is much easier than English for me. But from now I'm going to do it in English, and this is my first English tutorial on YouTube. In my videos I'm going to show you how to use different comments, techniques and tricks to make a jewelry model in Rhino or Matrix software. From now, we are going to start with essential, and we will reach the advanced level in the next few videos. Do not forget to subscribe my channel for the upcoming videos, and if you like them, please click on the like button. Let's go and check what we are going to learn in the first video. This is the Rhinoceros 7 interface. You can find the commands and tools in three different parts of the software. All of them is the same, just different way to find them. You can find the tabs at the top, or you can find them in the icons at the standard menu or the left menu, or you can write them in the command bar. For example, I can select the curve from here, or write the curve in the command bar and draw curve, or we can find it in the curve menu at the tabs. It's not important which one you're using, it depends on you which one is more comfortable for you. And also we have four different views when we're opening the Rhinoceros, and with double click on each one you can maximize them. We have four different view: perspective, top, front and right view. And also you can shift between views. If you maximize one of them, you can shift between them using these small buttons at the bottom part and the left. So let's go to the perspective, and in all the views, by do right click on the tab in here, you can change the mode of the screen. For example, it's now on rendered, you can see the shadows will appear, or gusted, it's look like a gust, you can see inside the object, or you can get back to the shaded mode or a wireframe. You can do it for every different views, you can set different type of shade mode for your screen. And if you want to orbit or move inside your interface in your screen, you can use a right click to orbit all around the object. If you hold shift and use right click, you can pan, and zoom is in the scroll on your mouse, and again shift for the pan, and usually you can do without holding any key, just moving the mouse with holding right button of the mouse, you can orbit around the shape. But perspective is a 3D view. In other views like top, front and right, when you hold the right key it will pan automatically, because it's a 2D view, it's not 3D. So there is no orbit option, you don't need to hold the shift, just need to hold the right click and pan. So let's get back to the perspective. And I want to show you how you can select the objects. If you use left click on each object, you can select them one by one. If you hold shift and click on two objects, you can select both of them. If you want to deselect one object, you have to hold control and click on object, and it will remove from your selection. And you can use window for selection. If you draw a window from left to right, you can see only the object which is inside, totally inside the window, it will select. For example, if I draw a window from left to right and one of the objects totally inside and another one is not totally inside the window, it will not select. But if I do it from right to left, it's just enough to touch the object. Let's check. If just touch any object, it will select. So this is another type of selection. There is a grid plane over here which is called C-plane in Rhino, and this is the zero point here, the intersect of these two vectors, green and red. Here is the zero point, we will try to design and draw everything around this point, because it's a good reference for us to understand where is my model and where is the axis if I want to do mirror, rotate, or array, or any other commands which you will learn in the future. So it's really important to stick around the zero point. And when I'm talking about the zero, you should understand this is the zero point, because in the future I will talk a lot about using the zero for axis, for rotating, or for a reference. Another good feature on Rhino, you can find it in many softwares, is it's Gumball. This is the Gumball, these arrows and these circles and small squares here. They're doing different things for us. These arrows can do move in three different directions. And if you want to drag them, just need to click and drag. If you want to move them with number, just need to do one click without any drag and add the number. For example, now I'm working in millimeter. If I will enter 10, enter, it will comes up for 10 millimeter. Another one, these small boxes are doing scale for us. If I just click and drag, it will scale in one direction. If I want to scale it by number, for example, in this direction, the green direction, I can just one click on the small box and add the number, for example, 1.2. It's about 2% bigger in just one direction. If you want to scale it in whole directions, in three directions, you just need to hold the shift and drag that small box. We have another types of scale, but this is an explanation of Gumball, and it's really useful tool. If you don't have it already on your Rhino, you can go on the Gumball button here at the bottom part and select and click on it. It will appear on your screen when you select anything. It doesn't matter it's a curve or it's a solid or it's a surface, it's not important. Whenever you click, you can find it out. But when you select a curve, the Gumball have some extra features. These small dots, these are not available in Rhino 5 if you're using Rhino 5, but in Rhino 6 and 7, if you just click on them and drag, it will extrude it for you. It's a really good feature. And also in surface you can do the same. It will extrude the surface and make it solid. In Rhino 5 and older versions, when you are trying to do it with Gumball, you should hold the control and do it, and it will extrude it for you. But for now, in Rhino 7, you just need to click on that small dot and drag. But just remember, in solids you cannot use this feature because they're already extruded, so you cannot do it. So let's talk about another thing in the objects and selection in Rhino. This is a polysurface which is made by six different facets or six different faces. If we want to select one of these facets or one of these face, we have to hold Control and Shift and use left click to select one of them. So what we can do now, we can move it, we can rotate, or we can scale. This is a really useful tool for some of our designs. It's really good feature, sometimes it can help us. But another thing that you can select is the edges. Another part of every object in the Rhino, also surfaces have an edge. It's a little bit tricky to select them, but same as before, you have to just hold Control Shift and try to select the edge. You can do the same with them, use Gumball to move them, rotate, or anything else. And also you can use move from here or right move. Now I'm select move from the menu. When you select the command, it will write here for you, select objects to move. You will select the object that you want to move. If it's just one, after selection, you can use right click, a space, or enter. All of them is the same for all the commands. So now I'm using right click. Then it will ask you point to move from which point you want to move. I will use here as a reference, these are the snaps. When I get close to the end points, it will appear. For example, you can also find the midpoint, is the middle of this edge of this box. If these are already off for you, you can go here or snap, turn on, turn off. You can see the small box at the bottom part, will become gray, or add a little bit shiny or highlight. When it's in highlight, it's on, and then you can select which snaps you want to use. Already we need end and midpoint, so turn these two on. You want to move it from midpoint. I told you you're trying to work on zero, so I select from midpoint, and then I want to put it on zero. There's no snap on zero, but if I write zero, enter, it will move from this midpoint to the zero point. It will come here. So it's really important to know how to move objects to the zero, because we're working a lot with them. So let's go to the next feature that we want to talk about. In Rhino, when you want to draw a surface, you should draw a line first. When you want to draw a solid, you should have a surface. So the steps is going like this. Draw a line, move the line, make the surface, and move the surface, make the solid. Let me show you. There is a line which I'm drawing, and I will move the line, then I have the surface, and then I will move the surface, and I have the solid. This is how it works. For all the designs, we do the same, but not always with the Gumball. We have other features. We have commons, which is called extrude curve, extrude surface, different type of surface makers. We have lots of features that we will work on them in the future. But for now, we have to learn how to work with the curves, because if we don't have a good curve, we cannot make a good surface. Because usually we are not using a plain surface, plain rectangular surface. It's so basic. So we have to learn how to handle a curve. What does it mean? How we should handle the curve? Let me bring an example for you. Click in the small triangle over here. Select the add picture plane. You can find a dome picture or a can picture or a glass picture. Just search whatever you want in Google. For example, can vector, or for example, glass vector. It will bring it for you. You can download and import it inside the Rhino. When you bring it, just use the move command from midpoint to zero. Just make sure it's a symmetrical shape. It's really important for this exercise and for this train. It's really important. So use the lock option here. Make it lock. It will not move anymore. Let's go to the top view and select the control point curve from here and try to make the outline of this shape. This is what is exactly meaning of handling the curve. We are trying to draw a curve that we need. We want to learn how to make a circular shape. I will make it a little bit simple. Let's see, you can see I'm doing some mistakes. And maybe you will ask how we are going to solve it. I will show you. This is all about handling curve. This is our curve. When you want to finish the command, you have to use the right click, space, or enter. For example, I start the curve, I draw something, so now I want to finish it here. I will do right click and it's finished. Or you can do the same, or space, and it's finished. Or you can here, and now we want to finish, you can use enter. All of them is the same. Right click, space, or enter will finish your command, or start your command, or it will restart the latest comment which you have used. For example, for now, the latest comment that we have used, it was a curve. Now I will do the right click, so the right click will start again. So we have the curve here. We want to handle it. In the latest version of Rhino, when you select the curve, you can see the control points automatically. If you are using the older version of Rhino, you should click on the curve and select this option. This option is show object control points. It will bring you the control points. Then you can edit them. What you are going to do, you're going to edit them. We are trying to handle them and make them much closer to the object. This is just an example of handling curves. You should try to decrease the points, but keep the shape. For example, if I want to keep the shape here and decrease the points, what should I do? For example, there is an extra point in here. I will select it and use the delete from my keyboard. Now the shape is still the same, but I decrease the points. More points means more complexity. We don't need extra job in Rhino. We're trying to make the job as less as possible. We don't want to add extra details. Each one of these points means details for us. In the future, when we are going to the complex models, we'll understand how important it is. So it's really important to spend some time on it and try to handle the curves. So let's make it. Now I will do right click on this lock and it will unlock the object. The surface was unlocked. Now we'll delete it. Let's go to the perspective. Now I want to make this dome with this outline. What is it doing? What should I do? We have a line now. We said we have to move the line to draw the surface. This is a dome, so it should move around a point on a circle. We have a command which is called revolve. Revolve, you can find here. Select the curve to revolve. It will ask us select the outline which you want, which we draw now. I will select and then right click. It means go to the next step. In the next step, it will ask you a start of revolve axis. Where is the axis of revolve? The axis is around the zero. I told you we will draw around the zero. So I will type zero, enter. This is the start of axis. Hold the shift, it will become 90 degree line, and click for the end of the axis. So now you can see this curve is moving around these axis. The start angle on zero, I will do right click, it's the start point. And this is a total circle, so it must be at the end of 360 degree. Then I will click right click and it's finish the comment. And now we have the dome, it's just need to be rotate 90 degree. We have these small arcs to use for rotation. So we'll click on it and add 19 degree, it will rotate. And now we have our dome. This is an example of how Rhino think. Rhino understand when you tell them, please rotate this curve and draw a line for me. But usually our designs, maybe it's not a circular shape or it's not a dome. We have many, many other ways to do it. For example, we have sweep 2 comment. What is sweep 2? Sweep 2 needs two rail. I will draw an example. These are two rails, which is show us where is our surface gone and where is the start and the end. These are the rails, here is the start, and here is the end. So it means four different line. I will go and select sweep 2 from here. Rail number 1, rail number 2, first cross section and the second cross section, then right click. The pop-up will come and you will select OK. Now you can see, we will use different curves for a different type of designs. So it's really important to handle the curve, because if I cannot draw the curve which I want, I cannot make the surface which I need. So this is the first video, and this is the first thing that you should know. You should spend time to draw your rails, draw your outlines of the domes of a glass or any other shapes that you want to make. After that, you can start to make more complex shapes and combine them. And now we can combine these two, but we will keep it for the next video. I hope you will enjoy it. Please don't forget to subscribe if you like, and if you want the upcoming videos, please turn on the notification with this small bell. And also, if you like it, please like it for me. And if you have any question, advice, or suggestion, you can write down in the comments. I will answer as soon as possible. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next week with the new video and new features of Rhinoceros.